Hello friends, I am Hitesh Agarwal from PHP Academy. Today we are going to learn about bundle product. What is bundle product? How we can create it? So what is bundle product? So bundle product is a, you can see it as a kit as well. It is a composite of sample or virtual products. So where customers can add or configure sample or virtual product according to their needs into a bundle product. So this is the product where customers can select different types of products into from a single product page. For example, if you are selling computer, so you can bundle it with keyboard, mouse, CPU, like that. So you can create a bundle product where you can add simple product for keyboards, simple products for mouse. So it will be a single product page where customer can configure like different types of keyboard, different types of RAM, like 64 GB RAM, 128 GB RAM, like that. So customer can configure and buy it in a bundle. Okay. You can define a dynamic price. You can define dynamic SKUs for the bundle product. Okay, so when the customer will select the options, the price will be added into the cart. So we will learn more by example. So let's go to screen. So I will go to products page. So from here you can select simple, virtual and bundle. So suppose let me I will create bundle product directly from here. So I will select any attribute set. I am not selecting anyone. So I will give bundle product one. Okay, this is my product name. You can give any product name like computer or whatever you want as per your requirement. SKU, you can also use dynamic SKU. So whenever any products will be sold in a bundle product, so its SKU will be bundle product SKU with simple or virtual product SKU. Okay, so you can use this. If you don't want to use a dynamic SKU, so you can disable it. And when any orders will be placed, it will be the with this SKU only. Okay. So here we will use dynamic SKU. Then price, you can use dynamic price as well. Dynamic price means when customers will select the options, the price will be added into the cart of that SKU. So I will show you both example. First we will take with the dynamic price and dynamic SKU. Then we will take one example with the non-dynamic and non-dynamic price. Okay, so here you can select other attributes as per your requirement. So here you can see bundle items options. So from here you can add option. Then I am selecting first option. You can use option as per your choice, like keyboard, RAM, hard disk, whatever. First option. You can use different input types, like if you want to select use drop down, or you can use radio buttons, you can use checkbox, you can use multiple select. So I will use radio button. Then from here you can make it required or optional. So if you will tick mark, then it will be required with that, means without this product, without this option, customer cannot add that bundle product into the cart. If you will untick it, so it will be optional. So customers can add or cannot add as per his requirement. So it will be optional for customer. So we will take two options, one with required and one with optional. So from here, you can add the product into the option. Suppose I will add these three products. So I have added three products into this first option. Let me take another option. So it is like example, like you have a three different types of keyboard. So you can write keyboard and give three options. So customer can select one of them as per his choice. Then option two, I will take drop down and make it optional. So here we will use three different. Okay. So I have added three different products. Okay. So now you have to define the default quantity. It will be like minimum quantity which customers needs to purchase. You can add one, you can add two. So if you will add one, minimum is one you have to add. Okay. So if you will define five, when customer will select this option, it will be automatically the five options, five quantity he needs to purchase. So I will save it. Other options you can select as per your choice. I already showed other options in our simple products video. So you can check that video for all these options. So I will open front end. So you can see here we have bundle product, and you can see from the starting price and ending price. It is coming based on the options we have used in our bundle product. So when you will click on customize and add to cart button, it will show you the options for bundle product. So this is your first option. This is your second options. So when you here you can see the price is zero. Why it is price is zero? Because we are using dynamic price. So once you will select any options, suppose I ex select this option, so the price is changed and my first option is here. Okay, so this is the price of this bundle product with this option. Okay, now I will select option two. So it will give me it will add 74 in the 38. So it will give me total amount. Okay, and here you can see both options. If I don't want this option, so I can just leave it as it is. So it will be 38. So I will add this product into the cart. So you can see here, this bundle product has been added to the cart. Okay. So if I will add both, so you can see the op bundle product has been added with both option. Okay, with 112. Okay, so this has been added. Let's place order. Let's go to orders. So you can see here, we have order with bundle product one. We have two bundle product. One is only with one option. One is with two options. And here you can see SKU is dynamic. So bundle product, and this is the simple product SKU. Okay. Here also you can see. Okay, so here you can see both two SKUs because we have selected two options, and here you can see only one SKU because we have selected only one option. Okay, so this is with dynamic SKU. Let's add with simple without dynamic price and dynamic without dynamic SKU. So I have to create new product. Bundle product two. So I am disabling it, and I am disabling it as well. So if I will disable it, so it will give me advanced these prices, and here I can use any prices. So when it means any, if any customers will add this product to the cart, so nevertheless any options customer selected, but price will be fixed. Okay, but price for the options we can control if still. So let's come here, add product, add option. So I will add first option, radio button. So you can still here you can add the prices. So these prices, when customer will select this option, so these prices will be added over this price. So it is, if it is 100 and customer select this option, so 10 will be added into the price. So I will take one with 10 and other with 0. So you can leave it blank as well. So by default it will be 0. Here you can select 1. I will add another option. Take drop down optional. So here I am not selecting any price. Let's select 10 or 30, 1, 1. So let's click on customize and add to cart. Here you can see the default price is 100 because I am not using dynamic price. So it will be a fixed price of this bundle product. So if I will select this, it will not change anything in the price. Okay, so it is not taking the price of this product is Q. Okay, whatever price is for assigned to this product, so it will not reflect. If I will select this, it will add $10 in this $100 because I have given the price for this product in the option. Okay, so same here, if I will select this, it will add 30. If I will select this, it will not add anything in this price. Okay, so let's add to cart. So you can see here bundle product 2, and here you can see SKU. You can see difference, like in previous orders there was simple product SKU also added into the SKU. So now it is not added because we have disabled the dynamic SKU. So only bundle product SKU will be here. Then you can see first option and option 2. So here you can see the price is 1110. Okay. So this is the bundle product, and hope you understand how we can create it and what is the use of this product, because use is simple. Like if you want to sell any product as a bundle, as I said example, that if you are selling computer, you want to sell keyboard with the computer, you want to sell mouse with the computer, so you can sell it in you can create a bundle. Okay, so like that you can create a bundle product. So if this video helpful for you, so please like our video and add any comments in the comment box how you rate this video, and also if you have any doubts and issues with the Magento. So just add in the comment. I will try to solve your problems. Thank you. Keep watching.